Hello everyone, I'm back here again with another toy review on the Dragon Ball Z SH Figure Arts Riku figure! And what do you think about this figure?
I heard you complaining a lot about it.
There's a one major, two gripes, one major on my figure. I don't know if you can see, but I do have a sticky tack on one of the arms. His butterfly joint is just super loose, so I had a hard time standing him in this pose because his butterfly joint just wanted to keep flapping out. I will get to that a little bit later. This figure is really cool. I love how big he is. He's very thick. Kind of hard to pose because of the... We'll get into that as well. I'm sure those of you who have this figure are having somewhat of a hard time posing this guy without having some stuff falling out. I wish they made this guy a lot more solid like Nappa. Nappa, he's very solid for his size and don't have to worry too much about anything falling out with this figure. I mean, they're trying to be fancy, but at the same time, it's kind of annoying. But looking at him, I do enjoy this figure. If you were wondering where I got this figure from, I got it from hobby-genki.com. They're always super good with their customer service, and they're always sending their figures out super fast, and they're always one of the first to receive their figures. Now, what we're going to do is take this figure off the stand, take a good look at the box, take a good look at accessories, take a good look at this stupid figure. All right, and taking a look at the box, this is a windowsill saw packaging like always with a crew in the front. Got him on the bottom, got him on the sides, wind on this side, wind on the top. And all the poses that you can get this guy into. And the ceiling of this toy animation sticker to show that this is not a bootleg. All right, and before we get into the figure, he does come with some accessories. He comes with a yelling face. Looking off to the side. So basically they're all yelling faces, but he's just looking in different directions. You got one looking forward. I just love how these look exactly like the anime. I wish we had a Bucktooth one for battle damage. Of him yelling off to the side as well. And he does come with a ton of hands. He has a fist that you can already see. He has two gripping hands right here. And they're fairly big. He has two key blast hands. And then he has two chop hands. And then two chop going upwards hands. He also comes with a Namekian frog. And I really like the detail to this. Let's take a look at the frog here. So it really does look like the Namekian frog. I don't think they put a black pupil on there. Yeah, it's not drawn in. It's still very well detailed. It's just like it. So we got that. And then we got Captain Ginyu when he turns into a frog as well. That one's pretty hilarious. So we're going to bring out Captain Ginyu. See how he looks. It's going to take his head off, put the dumbass face on, and with the dumbass face. Yeah, he looks pretty lost over there. And getting into the figure itself, looks like him a lot. Do like the little shading that they put in his mouth. That way you can make out that he's smiling. He really has that dumb look on his face. I wish we had a Bucktooth face. If you're wondering how to change out the face, all you do is pull it off like so. Take the hair off. And then take the scout off. There you have it. I do wish that they had an ear like Bardock. All you do is place the hair on top like so. And at first it's kind of hard to put the hair on these heads. It still kind of is hard to get on all the way. Put the scout on like so. And then you put it onto his head like so. So yeah, that's how you put the head on. The rest of the body. Just really like how well sculpted the muscles are. Now my gripe is when you get to pose this guy, it's super annoying. First of all, there's a sticky tack over here for his arm, reason why I have it there. Shit. And that's the gripe number one. Gripe number one is these tabs keep flying off and the head keeps flying off. These tabs come off so freaking easy. It just pisses me off. Well, that's gripe number one. With this damn figure. Number two is his butterfly joint is floppy as fuck. Look how floppy that is. Every single time I try to have him pose, it just... Look at that. That's not good for a $100 figure.
$100?
It should not be flopping out like that. Look at this shit. This is like China made. What the fuck? This is not the way it's supposed to be. Look at that shit. It's supposed to be more solid than that. So that is a fucking bummer. That pisses me off here. Because the butterfly joint is just so freaking floppy. And those shields is all floppy on him. Shield pieces. His head flies off easily. So for those of you customizers, of course, we're going to see somebody do the naked version of him. Yeah, I just don't like that floppiness of the butterfly joint. I love the fact that the butterfly joint goes out that far, but I don't like the fact that it is floppy as fuck. It's super floppy, and it just pisses me off. Now, another gripe. The shoulders is so fucking tight, I can't... Look at that! Oh my god! I don't know who else has that problem, but his shoulders is just so tight. Every single time I want to move his arm around, it's just so freaking tight. And it just loosens the freaking butterfly joint. And the head just keeps flying off! Ugh! I don't care if nobody watches this review or if I get a ton of dislikes. This figure just pisses me off. It looks good, but this is not good. Getting articulation, he does look up, he does look down, and his head comes off. His arm goes about that high, he has a bicep swivel, he has double jointed elbows, he has a wrist hinge and a swivel. He has an ab crunch that works really good. It crunches at 2 points, then it crunches back at 2 points. His leg kicks up out that high, kicks back about that high. He does a split, his double jointed knees. He has a hinge and a swivel and a rocker and a toe hinge. Figure looks good, just there's a lot of problems with this guy. And here I have Raccoon standing with his Captain Ginyu. And geez, all we're missing is Gudo and Bird. Fuck. I don't care anymore. And here's Goku with the stupid frog. Do you want to say anything?
No comment. You're so hyper.
This review, I'm just so frustrated because he's just a crappy figure to play with. The only reason why I'm collecting him is so that way I can finish these five guys. With all that said, do you have anything you want to say? I'm pretty sure I will. I mean, this figure was $100. Just to have a lot of problems. The shields keep popping off. His head keeps popping off. His butterfly joints are loose. His shoulders are way too tight, and he's just not fun to pose because I'm just too damn busy picking up accessories off the ground because they just keep popping off. Just like Ginyu, these figures, I don't know, they look good, but it's just pissing me off, man. Nappa is so solid. He's nothing like these new figures. Nappa, look, I can shake Nappa around. His shield will stay on. All his shoes were stained. Why didn't they just stay with this? Why didn't they just stay with this type? Why are they trying to make something that works good like that? When I play with Nappa, I do not pick up any of his shield pieces off the ground. He's just solid made and just smooth all over. Same price. So I do not get why I have a hard time posing this guy and picking shit off the floor, and his shits keep popping off, and his fucking his butterfly joint sucks, and his shoulders tight. What the fuck, man? This is a premium fucking figure, and they're just making it hard for us. I don't get it. They make it hard to get, and when you get it, it's just a piece of shit. I'm sorry that this review is very negative, but this whole Ginyu Tokusentai, they're just all pieces of shit. They just fall apart like easy. They all fall apart. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Can I throw it too?
No.